Hi there, and this is Sir Jellybean, and I'm basically doing a bit of a walkthrough on Conquest, how to play it, some of the basics, and then we'll show some actual combat. So a bit more of an interesting video to my previous guides. So let's begin. So this is your basic, kind of the campaign map for the dynamic Conquest. There's your HQ, there's the enemy. The objective is to move from the points, so multiple battles to the enemy HQ, and then you win. As you mouse over them, different levels of risk. As you can see, different things to earn, such as manpower, munitions, and or research if they're available, and support stars, which I'll explain for. And they all have different maps, so for instance, I'll probably go for the three risk first. Here you've got reinforcements, that's all the stuff you can bring when you've unlocked them. Cost it various different points and manpower caps. Support, which are used support stars, that's airstrikes. And they also have some firepower on them, so they can machine gun the target as well. Very interesting. You've got manpower, which is used obviously to purchase things. And you've got research, which is the research tree. So you can unlock things, new tanks, new armoured units, infantry, AT guns, you know, ECT. This is your veterans, it says, but this is basically the army you buy. And that's where they are. And then this is your deployment screen, where you're actually deploying to the battle, plus support elements. So we'll start with the research screen, always go for an officer, calling stage 2, so you can bring a bit more. We've got it on hard, not hardcore, because I'm an okay player, but not that good. And always go for a rifle squad, because they've got the LMG in there, always needed. Now this is an interesting one, you can go, I always advise going for armour, personally, but it depends what route you want to take. Now you could go armoured car route, but they are pretty light, you're not going to get much out of them early on. Normally I go for the Panzer 1. And then that'll do me for now. So, and then we'll build, so two, three. So I like to have three rifle squads, a Panzer one. Always like to have a medic and some ammunition. Oh, that's tank crew, oh, that was close. Medic, and we've got enough for another rifle squad. So always a good call. So first wave, dual rifle squads, Panzer one. And then rifle squad, ammo crate, medic. Always bring an ammo crate, simply because it will save your supplies in the long run. And if you've got lots of manpower, which you will later in the game, you can buy them, resupply troops in the match, and just delete the unit and rebuy for manpower, because sometimes supplies is a bit low. And you can always check out the map. So this is Viasma. It's not a bad little map, actually. Normally I spawn this kind of side, depends where it gets you. And we'll go into the battle. So, hard AI, which means normally the AI is not amazing, but you know, when the game's good, it's amazing. When it's not so good, it's okay. But they always have more stuff in you, and they'll call in reinforcements, as you'll see, sometimes tanks, sometimes infantry, but always good to be on your toes and keep troops on your flanks as well, because you might think you're safe, but a T-34 pulls up behind you and ruins your day. And sometimes it can be as simple as just a partisan squad showing up with Molotovs, and they hit your tiger at the wrong point, and yeah, it can definitely damage your battle plan, because losing one or two vehicles at the wrong spot can make it near impossible to do it without heavy casualties. So sometimes you have to abandon it, and that can make defence even more difficult, because you've got less resources and you'll come up against quite heavy units later into the game. And you, yeah, so this is the map you spawn on. As you can see, you can zoom around it. You've got 2 points to take, so point B and point C. So as you see, this one on a bit of a hill, always good to get low to the ground, and you can actually see the terrain. Like, say for instance, if infantry are approaching here, MGs there would not be able to see them if they're prone, so you can get things a lot closer. Also good to see the lay of the land for if like units are moving through, where they can actually see if enemy AT guns in certain positions. For instance, if the enemy's got AT on here, it's going to be able to see things like tanks at the distance and infantry, but as you get a bit closer, infantry would be like harder to see. But for instance, the hill will block line of sight. So always get close and check out the environment. Check, for instance, most of the building line of sight blockers are behind them, so it's going to be a hard position to attack from the front. It's also got barbed wire and trenches, so I'll probably make a move to go for this one first. It's quite far away though, because then I'd have to flank around. I'm going to have to probably go straight for that. So you spawn your troops in, as you see, they'll arrive. Four rifle squads, medics, Panzer 1, awesome little tank, and some ammo. Should be enough. And we shouldn't have too much heavy stuff. So I always like to put one squad kind of on the flank. And the other three I will move up there. And normally, so they must have changed on the update, you can actually move around this right flank here. I'm normally playing on Conquest Enhanced, this is just vanilla, but it's cut off because normally you can flank around the hill. So we're probably going to have to go a bit full front of the sword for this. Not always advised. You're supposed to, you know, be a bit more intelligent, but... Well, I've removed the wrong squad. So I'll put these on the flank just in case anything tries to push to the side of us. And we've got a bit of cover there, but I'll move these up and just leave them in the tree line. This should be okay up there. And the ammo crate can just hang around here. It's a really cool game if you've not played it. It's basically Men of War Assault Squad 2's next predecessor, even though they're making the actual Men of War 2. But Gates of Hell has a lot of the original team. And really passionate about the project. It's not perfect by any stretch of the matter, there's a lot of issues still, but when it's good it's phenomenal, and when it's bad it's kind of a pain in the ass, but it's a very fun game. And like, for instance, the image you just want to see, 22 frags, 6 anti-tanks, 8 smoke, different swords, different grenades, so it adds a bit of randomization, adds a bit of realism that not everything's the exact same, which I quite like. So I've engaged infantry here. The tank's going to do most of the heavy lifting. Troops are picking up, hitting to prone, just hit control. Easy attack, infantry to support the tank. Always good to send your infantry first, just in case the enemy's got, for instance, 80 rifles in the service stage. We'll rip through this thing. There's only 2 crew, so it's easy to disable. Third squad's going to start pushing up slowly. Just there. These guys can get up now. He's going to be suppressed as soon as he steps up. So if he comes out, the tank can deal with him. There we go, there. Fire. Engage. Let's chuck a cheeky frag there, get red. Troops can't fire on the move either. It could originally, but they stopped it, because they kept just running and shooting. So you have to be still to fire, so if you're charging enemy MG, you aren't going to be spraying as you go forward. So just remember that. That's him gone. Frag grenades are really good, by the way. And the AT grenades are better for the Russians, but the Germans do have bundles that can deal with light things as well. So, not too much for this map against us. Some infantry. I'm not seeing the AT. The tank's going to slowly move up. Just move there, try and keep them not too close. Just in case. Keep moving the infantry squad up. The infantry is actually going to go to the flank here. We'll try and push them around the edge. We'll get in this trench first, actually. And we'll try and get them pushing up a different way. See, the MG doing a lot of work there. Quick people down, suppressing. Always good to have the rifle squad there instead of the squads. Your session with the quad, I believe. Basically, equivalent to conscripts, pretty much. You want the rifle squad, you want the MG. And, yeah, it's just a better troop altogether. They have more health and stamina than the standard troops. Yeah, definitely worth bringing. And the MGs are just amazing. Always worth having. So I'm double clicking here, making them push forward quick, ignore the target, getting decent thing, then just tank to all those down. They should be able to get him. Get him in. They should be able to target. Yeah, they're getting there. So there's not too much opposition, nothing in the trench by the looks of it, but being careful because the Russians do have decent anti-tank grenades and Molotovs at the early stage. Very easy to take tank lines out, so you've got to be careful. Panzer 1 will mow things down. I'm not seeing any AT rifles. Oh, there's one. Just sighted him. Panzer 1, engage. He's reloading. Not good. Oh, I'm going to have to take over. Bit of a threat. Oh, he's still alive, guys. You're going to have to go on the knees and start firing. That's it. Right. Get him in the trench, quick. Get him in that trench, get him in some cover. And they should be able to deal with that. Yeah, so they're doing some damage now. I'm going to chuck a couple of frags up as they're being suppressed down by the tank and the infantry. Squad should be able to move up with a little resistance. That's it. Get those frags in, boys. Quick, quick, quick. Beautiful work. Get them down to kneeling. And send this squad up here. We'll get them into a bit of cover. There is still that guy there, but if we're getting some decent cover, we should be right. Chuck a frag there as well. No, he's gone. That's no need. And that's it. First position taken. Not too much resistance. Always good to spread your troops out now. Don't make it too easy for him. Panzer's there. We're going to switch him round to... Well, to attack this position, it would actually be easier just to go straight kind of back. So we'll push off here and I'll get the ammo crate to meet him. Always good to keep your troops supplied. Saves on your resources. This squad. The enemy reinforcements should be coming that way, so I'm actually going to move them up prone that way. This troop, get them prone just in case. Kind of move them there, get a bit of overwatch. Got a spear squad here. Double time it over there. This squad should be enough to hold. Boys, I like to spread the troops out a bit, get a bit more vision what's coming around. Also means if there's any high explosives or anything, you're not going to get taken out too quick. Most of the stuff should come from the south-southwest. Get some in this... there, they can't really see out of there. Chuck them over here. That shouldn't be too bad. Gives you a nice bit of cover. And get another couple of guys up there. If it gives you... Sometimes it's a bit finicky to actually get the cover to work. You have to go individual soldiers quite a lot. It's a pain in the ass, but... Ah, there's a couple of guys over here. I had a dealt with them. Love this stuff. It's good to always capture, kill those last remaining pains in the ass. And the medics are okay. We'll send one up here, and we should chuck one up here just in case. So, get the ammo to resupply. Just going to move these up like that. This squad as well. We'll slowly move them up prone, just in case there's enemy armour. This squad's also going to move up this way. Got a nice wide kind of approach. You don't want to bunch up too much just in case there's a Maxim, because you might think your troops are tough, but wait until a Maxim is really good. The Russian LMG, everyone talks about the MG42, but it's the gun shield on it. It makes it quite hard to take out sometimes, and it will just shred infantry. So we'll get them in the trench. Tanks will be up the road. Ammo can just hold back. Don't put it too risky, same with a medic. Oh, so the infantry's engaged to target. We've got enemy infantry. Is it a squad? Yeah, it's a squad. So they're moving up to attack the defensive position. But they probably wouldn't make it too far anyway, to be honest. You know, they've not got much. I'm actually going to pull these back because they're a bit too spread out. I'd like to have a few more guys together. Use that weight of fire. So this squad, as you can see, difference to the train, you can't actually see. So I'm going to move them up there. And move that squad there. There's enough of them to hold that. So we're going to keep pushing. The tank's going to support us. We've got to be careful of potential Maxim. So if you look at that terrain, for instance, those troops are actually going to be able to get fairly close before they even are seen. The tank should be able to engage any targets quite easily. The troops there, we're going to slowly push them forward. And we'll get the ammo crate just ready there in case we need it before the end of the match. This one's still engaging that troop. We're actually going to get some of these guys in cover. It's not the best bit of cover. Actually, they're okay there. They're in a good spot. The enemy eye is just kind of feeding into it. So, not too much for the threat here. Oh, go to that. Slowly move these up. We'll just push the tank up with them. That's a lot of infantry there. Right, so as you can see, the eye does throw a lot at you. Now, these are partisans, so they're pretty poor. But they can be a threat if there's large numbers. These should be able to chew them up. They're kind of running straight at them. That lip is a pain in the ass, I didn't realise that. You see, for instance, the trench is not in a good spot really for defending that way. So we're actually going to switch these to there. These guys will help. This squad's doing its job, just cutting them to pieces, keeping them busy. Good stuff. So the main action, the tank's doing its job. We'll keep pushing these forward. These guys can now move up to the hill. Get on the lip of the hill. Double time. Start laying some fire down. Is that an MG or it's just a DP27, nothing too dangerous. Get them in cover and they should be able to stand out of it and they should be able to do the job. These guys push up again. I'm just going to push the tank a bit closer. A little bit risky for it, but we'll get those MGs pumping. So this squad here, for instance, they've got the MG. I'm just going to move them there. I'm going to move this one a bit closer. I'm just going to frag the objective. Frag grenades, use them a lot. You've got them to use, you might as well use them. Just chuck as many as you can with a squad. They'll chuck an absolute ton. It's a bit risky when they're pushing forward because the SPGs. But there is another squad covering them. Time to go prone. Once the base just demolish, as you can see. If you can get close, definitely with it. Right, there is the Maxim. So that's a pain in the ass. It smokes. Deploy your smokes, guys. I'm just going to switch the tank around to engage that. So this squad, he's going to start approaching now. Well, get this squad to double time a bit closer. So the smoke's covering them. Get them behind some cover. Oh, they could do a healing actually before they get there. Same with you guys. Move the tank forward. So just kill that SMG guy, and as you can see, the Maxim there. They have to get a bit close. Now, this tank's armor's so light, Maxim can actually penetrate it, but the AI's not shooting, luckily. So we'll take advantage of their stupidity. And we'll just nail the guy down. And that's it, that's the Maxim cleared. So that's the main threat gone. Set those guys into cover there. Rest of the squad around the flank in case there's anyone hiding. Not been paying attention to this much, but I didn't see any of our troops die. So they're doing a good job, keeping them busy. We'll bring the ammo up, resupply some troops if we need it. The tank should be able to hold up most of these. When it's loaded, I'll just push it back there a little bit. The smoke is obscuring us a bit, but should be able to deal with the threat fairly effectively. They're only part of it, yeah. So light stuff. This squad's absolutely annihilating them. They're pushing in, pulling it. They're just getting taken in. I've got bad silhouette against the sky. Should know that from military training. Yeah, easy enough match. Maxim in a bit of a weird spot, but that's it, and you can close the map. You can continue if you wish, if there's enemy tanks to steal. You can't steal the emplacements. But yeah, it's always good sometimes, if enemy tanks are in good condition, just to steal them and sell them. And this is the end screen, like the resource screen, shows you what you've gained. So 200 manpower, 2 research. Then the bonus was 200 manpower, a star, and 100 munitions, and then cost of the higher risk factor, another 200 manpower, 2.5 star, munitions, and a research point, and a bit of payback, that's for some of the stuff you lose, like or damage. Or so you come out with 603.2 manpower, 7.5 support star, 150 munitions, and 3 research. And you can game results is the kill tie, so we lost 1, they lost 56, so it's not bad. You can go into details of the unit, so for instance, tank got 9 kills, MG operated 3 times, got 12. The 14 basic here, Archman got 22 kills, so yeah, good. And then history will literally show you in the order people died. Who did we lose? We lost an MG assistant, poor guy, he'll be remembered. And then you've got back to your name, normal screen for conquest. So you can bring your guys back over from the deployment screen, you can resupply them. And most of the supplies will be for the infantry, and that'll be probably for the grenades. But that's not a major thing, I should have resupplied more, so it will hit me a little bit, but I'll be fine. And then, as you can see, we've taken that position. And our defence will be, the next map will be hills, which, oh, I hate that map to attack, but it's good to defend. And then you've also got more research points, more support, and more manpower. So that's just the first match, basics for conquest, and I'll be doing some more videos. Hope you enjoyed it, and you know, if you've got anything to say, leave a comment. If it's good, and if it's bad, tell me why as well, because I'm trying to get my videos better, so I'm sure there's lots of tips out there. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you on the next one.